As a cat after writing a check for $500.
Well, I'll feel even better the day we can tell the Sloans that we are quitting.
You won't have that pledge until after we make the final payment.
It's a gallbladder problem, almost surely.
Will she need surgery?
I told Gloria you two would understand about us asking for the deposit back.
We use it on a down payment on a house, and the owner refuses to let us out of the contract.
You should have told me before we were married that you never wanted to have kids.
You know what's going to turn things around? You and your baby. Because when Caroline sees you with your baby, she's going to want one.
That'll be 15 cents.
May I?
Thanks.
You come here often?
I don't get out much.
Well, that's a crying shame.
Where the hell have you been?
The YWCA.
Hank said you were at the Roadhouse.
I was.
Did you meet any fellas?
Yes.
Did you forget you were a married woman?
I didn't forget. I'm going to have a baby. Oh, Caroline.
I tell you, I was saying my prayers at the top of the ninth inning.
Son, everyone loses the ball in the sun every once in a while, but you were flat out daydreaming.
I'm sorry, Coach.
Woman troubles?
How do you know?
Only troubles a man has outside of his job are women or money. What have you done this time?
Well, nothing. I thought my fiance and I were going to have a small wedding. Family, a few friends. But now she wants to...
The whole kit and caboodle.
Yes.
Medgaff, marriage is a compromise. And a compromise, like a good right arm, has to be developed. Hard work and practice. So you better start practicing before the nuptials. Let me give you for instance. What do you say if your missy tells you to fill the church with daisies?
Daisies look a little silly, if you ask me.
You say, I think that's a good idea. Say it.
I think that's a good idea.
And what do you say if she tells you she wants her cousin to sing, I love thee truly, deed I do?
Oh, no.
You say, I think that's a good idea.
Well, I think that's a good idea, but Coach,
it's just like getting the cutoff, man. You gotta practice it until you can do it in your sleep.
Coach, how can it be a compromise if it's one side giving in all the time?
Son, let the little lady have whatever she wants on her wedding day so you can have whatever you want on the wedding night.
I think that's a good idea.
Got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to be affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In Between. To illustrate my last remark,
Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark.
What do they do just when everything looks so dark?
Accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
You don't think he likes me?
I think he likes me.
He may not after I tell him I'm gonna have a baby.
He has to hate the sin, not the sinner.
And you'll make a joke, that's why I don't want you in there. You don't take this seriously.
You take it seriously enough for both of us.
Al.
What Al? This can't be the first time Father Dreher has heard of pregnancy outside of wedlock.
And it wouldn't be the first time that he refused to marry a couple either.
Refuse? How could he refuse?
He might decide that a rush wedding isn't a good idea. He could think it wouldn't be stable.
Who cares what he thinks? He should do his job and keep his opinions to himself.
Giving his opinion is his job, in a way.
This is unfair, and I have agreed to everything. I don't have a criminal record. If he says no, I'm coming in there.
Oh, Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
If you're not out in 15 minutes, I'm coming in.
20 minutes, tops.
We're publishing the bands next week, and your last pre-cana class would be when? July?
So what about August? August 14th?
I'll be almost 6 months along by then.
6 months along?
Yes, Father. Okay, we'll go through everything I have and make a list of what we'll need.
I think that's a good idea.
Oh, fudge. I have a winter blanket and I have a summer blanket, but they're both blue.
What's wrong with blue?
Well, it's Charlie's favorite color. We should get your favorite color.
Well, I'm not choosy.
No, I'm not going to make you sleep under Charlie's favorite color just to be thrifty. What color do you like?
I don't care.
Well, do you like green?
Sure.
Great. We'll soak them in yellow dye and they'll come out green.
I think that's a good idea.
No. No, we can't use green as our wedding color because I want Linda to be my maid of honor, and she hates green.
It's up to you.
You know, I see the attendants in pink. You know, in scallop flounce skirts, sort of like tulips held head down. What do you think? Maybe lavender is better.
I think that's a good idea.
Lavender or pink?
They're both good ideas.
Don't you care?
Well, whichever one you choose is fine with me.
You don't care. I never thought I'd get married to a man that didn't care about his own wedding.
I care about the wedding. I just don't care. I mean, that is, I do care, but not a lot about the details.
The details or the wedding.
Well, then you should arrange the details the way you want them.
Because you don't care.
Well?
Next Wednesday. Don't make a scene.
Next Wednesday, I meet the Grand Inquisitor. Next Wednesday, we go on vacation. What next Wednesday?
Father Dreyer has agreed to perform the ceremony next Wednesday.
Why?
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 Oh. Why do you ask?
I want to know exactly what you had to agree to. I want to know the fine print.
You are impossible sometimes.
Me?
Yes.
Old Father Dreyer holds our lives in his hands, and I'm impossible? Why won't you tell me why he consented to marry us?
You'll make fun.
I will not. I am delighted and relieved he consented. I will not make fun.
He said I was a respected member of the parish and that to delay the wedding until I was further along would give scandal to the faithful. You're laughing.
I am not.
I can see you are.
I absolutely am not.
I can tell you think this is funny.
This is not at all funny.
You think it is fun. You're making fun. You are.
I am not.
Yes, you are. I can see you're laughing.
I am not laughing. I am smiling because I'm happy we're getting married.
No, you're laughing.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I am not.
Oh, I am married to a handsome man.
And you're wearing a beautiful smile. Where'd that come from?
I've been worrying all morning about buying the business, and I know...
Honey, we did our best. We just came up short.
Would you let me finish, Abel Davis?
Anyone who calls me handsome, I suppose she can finish what she's saying.
I know that we came up short. But we still have a week left to make that final payment. And a week is 7 days. And in 7 days, God created the earth.
He had more power than we do.
Now, we can't earn $100 in a week. And the bank won't loan us a dime, much less the Sloans loan us a penny. But...
This must be the part where God comes in.
But it occurred to me that we don't have to ask for a loan. We can ask for an advance. We're dependable. We have worked for those people for 25 years, and the only time I ever missed was when I gave birth to Robert, and the only time you ever missed was when you broke your arm, and you were back at work 2 days later. Now, we asked them for 2 months' salary in advance, that plus our checks for my night jobs. That gives us $106. I want you to ask Mr. Sloan for an advance.
Why me?
You and he get along much better than Ruth Sloan and I do, and you know it.
We don't get along any better. Who says we get along any better?
Just don't tell him about the business. Ruth Sloan finds out we're planning on leaving her, she will fire us before we get a chance to quit.
We don't get along any better. Who says
we get along any better.
Mr. Slalom?
Yes, Abe.
Gloria and I, we've worked for you for a long time.
Yes.
We've always been punctual.
Yes, you have.
I take pride in my job.
You do a fine job.
I've never asked for an advance before, not in 25 years, but
Abe, is there another woman?
What?
It would break Gloria's heart.
No, sir, there's no other woman. What I was about to say, sir...
Have you taken to gambling?
No, sir, I don't believe in gambling.
Then why, after 25 years, do you find yourself repeatedly asking for money?
It's personal.
I've always considered you an honest man, Abe. But I feel very uncomfortable with these recent requests. If you can't be forthright with me, I can't see my way clear to give you an advance.
I'd like to see him live on what he pays us. Another woman, right? What right does that man have to ask me about my personal life? Gambling. Gambling. Do I ask him how many bottles of scotch he drinks?
This means I have to ask Mrs. Sloan.
You have something to tell me, Gloria?
Yes. I've been with you for a long time.
A long time.
And I've never been late. And I've never missed a day except to have Robert.
Except to have Robert.
And I work hard when I'm here.
You do work hard. Gloria, you are such a treasure. And I don't want you to suffer anymore. I know how hard this is to tell me.
You do?
Yes. I know you chipped my Cridlin platter. I've been waiting for you to confess, but I hadn't realized how much you were agonizing over it. And I want you to know I have no intention of deducting the full price from your weekly pay.
You don't.
My goodness, no, you couldn't afford it. So I'm only going to deduct $1.50 a week until it's paid in full. And you'll hardly feel it that way.
Sergeant Haley, with utter disregard for his own personal safety, faces down directed enemy fire by Jerry. Hey, Jerry, yeah? Bang! Bang! These molds are better than any Hank and I ever had. I'm sure Baby Private Haley will approve.
What if Baby Private Haley turns out to be a girl?
Girls love them, too.
Oh, is that true, Emma?
Isn't that right? See, Emma thinks they're swell.
That little girl's a spitting image of her daddy.
I'm not her daddy.
Oh.
She's the mother, but she's not my wife.
Oh. He's a married man, but not to me.
Oh. Well, if anyone cares for advice from a stranger, and I'm not saying you should, there's no child been born yet that doesn't love a bunny rabbit.
You home? Come see what me and Gina got, honey.
What is it?
A bunny.
Oh, the bunny looks like Charlie, yes?
It's adorable. Emma must love it.
It's not for Emma, although I should have gotten her something.
Oh, it's okay.
It's for Baby Private Haley.
Oh, Charlie.
You don't like it? I could exchange it.
I'm not... It was a false alarm. I'm sorry.
It was a false alarm?
All the worrying during the strike must have put off my time a month.
Don't you know when you're expecting?
I thought I was. I've never had a baby before.
Didn't you go to the doctor?
How could I afford to? We weren't working.
Don't tell me you're pregnant. You don't know. When you don't even know.
I'm sorry.
Not mad at you for not having an opinion?
Yes.
You didn't tell me she was a thinker.
Oh, is that bad?
No. Just means you have to use some subtlety.
Subtlety?
For example, say she asks you what kind of wallpaper you want for the bedroom. All the samples are laid out in front of you. Even though you know which one you want right off the bat, take your time.
Make her think you're considering all the choices, you know.
And then tell her checks or whatever. It doesn't matter. Then it's her turn to tell you what she likes. And say she says morning glories, and you say, morning glories.
Try it. Morning glories?
She said morning glories, not the Martians have landed. Morning glories.
Morning glories.
Then take your time examining her choice. After which you say, morning glories, as if it's dawning on you that morning glories is the one and only appropriate choice for your wallpaper.
Morning glories. Morning glories.
There's nothing a woman likes more than thinking she's convinced a man of the rightness of her views.
I've narrowed our choice of china patterns down to these four. Now, we only have to register for China because I have a complete set of flatware I got from the box tops from my Raisin Bran. Not that I'm saying you care.
May I see the flatware, please?
If you're just humoring me.
Ah. Yeah. This one, fruit basket looks best with our flatware.
You think so?
Hmm.
What about Martha Washington?
Martha Washington. Martha Washington.
You barely looked at Cloverleaf.
Cloverleaf? Hmm. Oh. Martha Washington.
I don't like it.
You don't?
Pick from the other two.
Cloverleaf?
And Spanish moss.
Spanish moss. Spanish moss. Clover leaf.
Let's get Spanish moss.
Now, pardon me for saying this, but why do you ask my opinion? The only pattern I didn't pick was Spanish moss. Why are we registering for Spanish moss?
Well, if you're going to be that way about it, we don't have to get Spanish moss.
I'm not being that way. I just want to know why.
I can live without Spanish moss.
I don't care if we get Spanish moss or any other silly name dish. I just want to simply know why my opinion is so important on these matters when you're going to make up the decision yourself.
I didn't make the decision, did I? I said I could live without Spanish moss. Let's start again. Which one do you like?
Spanish moss. Marilyn Stone gave us this hideous Spanish moss tureen when we got married.
You sure you want to donate a wedding gift?
I can't imagine why I ever kept it in the first place, or why Marilyn ever gave it to us. I'd selected a completely different pattern. Besides, the Bethany Baptist rummage sale always inspires me to update my serving pieces.
It just dawned on me. Marilyn Stone must have received that tureen as a present herself and then passed it off to us as a new gift. How tasteless. Now, Glory, if there's anything you or Abe want, you pick it out before you give the boxes to Pastor Harrington. Oh, wait. I might as well get rid of that Cridlin platter you chipped. There.
What did the Sloanes donate this year?
I haven't looked through the boxes.
And you're not going to. I don't want another thing from that woman in my house.
Now, don't throw out the baby with the bathwater. The Sloanes spend good money on their things.
Well, you can go through it, but I'm not going to.
Just goes to show you. Money came by taste. I always hated Spanish moss.
Mm. I want you to make the announcement to the children.
I don't think that's a good idea.
It's a man's place to do it.
Not with grown children, it's not.
It will mean a lot to them to hear it directly from you. It'll mean a lot to Al to be able to tell you himself. So when he does, I want you to...
I'm surprised.
No, you don't have to pretend. I think it's fair for me to ask you to...
Be nice.
May I finish a sentence? I don't think it is too much to ask you to return his politeness in kind. And if you can't say anything charitable, then don't say anything at all.
Yeah, well, your mother and I are getting married next Wednesday. I never planned to fall in love with her, but I did. And I do love her. I will try to be a good husband. More than try, I will be. I will try to be. I don't want to be your father. You don't need one. I know you'll be a terrific older sister to the baby. I prepared that speech. Say something.
Thank you for that speech.
Your mother and I are getting married next Wednesday. I never planned to fall in love with her, but I did. I will try to be a good husband. I don't want to be your father.
I don't want you to be either.
You don't need one. I know you will be a terrific older brother to the baby.
Even though we live in a big house, I want you to know my mother doesn't have any money, so to speak. This house is mortgaged. She hasn't saved up much. Well, she is the finest woman I know. On the other hand, you I don't know very well, but from what I do know about you, I don't like you very much. I don't like what you did to her. I'm not going to tell her that. I'm going to smile every time we're in the same room together, but I'll be smiling for her sake.
Did you rehearse that?
No, sir, I didn't have to.
Your mother and I are getting married next Wednesday.
How did it go?
Great.
That gap. You look lower than a snake's chin.
Coach, I did everything you told me to do, and Ginger got mad at me for expressing my opinion.
So you're either spineless or too pushy, is that it?
Yes, sir, it seems that way.
This is worse than I thought. Normally, I don't like to pry into a player's private life, but I'd like to ask you a question of a rather delicate nature.
Go ahead.
Are you and Miss Zabel currently engaged in
any activity officially reserved for the state of holy matrimony?
No, sir. Well, Ginger is a devout Catholic. As am I. The church strictly forbids.
Son, did I ever tell you about Morton Charles?
No, sir.
Morton and I were teammates on the Indianapolis Hoosiers in the old Federal League. He was a pitcher, a real flamethrower. Could have taught our young Bobby Feller a thing or two about fastballs. Anyway, he was fixing to marry a gal kind of like your Ginger. You know, kind of feisty and independent-minded. Nothing he said or did was right. He couldn't win for losing. But I could see right away what the matter was. Wedding jitters.
Wedding jitters?
Comes from tension. Now, being the religious people that they were, Morton and his intended abstained from pleasures of the flesh. Unfortunately, circumstances kept pushing the wedding date later and later, and tensions began to mount.
I know all about those tensions.
I'm sure you do, son. Well, I tried explaining the situation to Morton, but he wouldn't listen. Being the good friend I was, and fearing that the tensions would prove too much for his poor fiance, I decided to help alleviate those tensions myself one night while Morton was visiting a sick aunt. It was a terrible mistake on my part. Morton came home early and found us. Naturally, I had to stop my activity, even though the young woman's tensions hadn't been yet relieved. In her frustration, she picked up a pair of scissors beside the bed and struck out at poor Morton.
She killed him?
No. Only cut off one of its appendages.
Good Lord.
Yes, sir. That was the night he was given his nickname, Morton Three-Finger Charles. Fastball's never the same. Eventually, he got cut from the team, turned to drink. One night, he passed out in the street, was run over by a milk truck. Attention is a terrible burden to carry.
You advise me to relieve some tension?
Not in any sinful way. I advise you to elope.
It is worth $145 wholesale. Not the Spanish moth, that ugly face with the silly man stuck on the front. We've got to get it back before the rummage sale starts. You're closer to the church, but there's no accounting for these bus schedules. I'll get a bus, and you get a bus, and we'll both head there.
Your list of wedding guests, I'll make out mine. Now put two X's next to must invites, one X next to if possibles, and a check mark next to invite to the church only, but not to the reception.
I'm not doing this.
Well, now you don't even care about our guest list.
I don't care. I don't care because I don't want to have a wedding.
Jeff, is it because of the Spanish moss?
I don't want to have a wedding because I want to elope.
Our mothers would kill us dead.
Well, this wedding isn't for our mothers, it's for us. Look, Ginger, I know we haven't seen eye to eye on things lately. But I also know it's because we both have the wedding jitters, and I know what causes these wedding jitters. Ginger, I can't bear to be without you one more day.
You can't bear to be without me?
I'll wait a minute longer than we have to.
Oh, I don't want to wait either.
You don't?
I don't. That's why I nearly made a fool of myself pushing Father Dreher to an early date. He's agreed to speed things along.
I love you. How soon till we can get married?
In only 6 months.
6 months?
Well, with any luck, I'll find a reception hall by then.
6 months?
Well, I had to notify my boss this morning. He has to prepare for my absence a week before and a week after.
6 months?
Is that all you can say, is 6 months?
We can't wait 6 months.
Okay, well, just check your game schedule, home games, road games, against the church schedule now. Rule out any dates where Father Dreher already has two weddings booked. Rule out Sundays, holy days of obligation, and you'll see there is nothing available until October.
Because I was a prideful woman.
Pride had nothing to do with it. It was the bus schedule.
We could have $145 in our pockets right now if I hadn't been too proud to take Ruth Sloan's hand-me-down.
It wasn't pride.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't. That vase was too ugly to keep anyway.
I only hope whoever bought it knows what it's worth.
I hate to think somebody bought it because they liked it.
What'd she look like?
English, 5'2", red hair, big dimple in her cheek when she smiles. Met her here about 6 months ago.
Dimples and a redhead, huh? Doesn't sound familiar, but then again, I'm new here.
If you met her, you'd remember.
That's so.
There was plenty to remember, you know what I mean?
Well, I'm going to say I don't, for the sake of propriety.
Can we afford this?
It'll take our minds off our troubles. Besides, we deserve a night out. Two checks coming in now. It's been a long time between drinks of water, as they say, in the desert. You get us a table. I'll get some beer. Excuse me.
Well, it isn't the proud father to be.
You got the wrong Joe. Two brews.
Aren't you the fella about the bunny rabbit?
Well, that's right. Gave it to my friend.
A friend who isn't your wife.
That's right.
A cute little bundle of joy.
Yes.
Who isn't yours?
Of course not.
But your wife's got one in the oven.
False alarm.
Sorry.
Wasn't your mistake.
So who are you with tonight? Your wife or your friend?
What, do you work for J. Edgar Hoover on your spare time?
Caroline? I guess it's true. Good things do come to those who wait. I've been hoping you'd walk in. Finally, you do, and I don't recognize you. You being all blonde now.
Go
don't
away.
Don't start swinging until I get a chance to apologize.
Don't sit down. You're not staying.
My wife is over there in the navy dress.
That's her? She's a knockout, your wife. Bet she'd look good as a redhead.
She used to be a redhead. I like her better as a blonde.
Do tell.
Charlie, there you are. I was beginning to worry about you. Mr. Mahoney, this is my husband, Charlie.
Your husband?
Pleased to meet you.
Mr. Mahoney was trying to sell me some jewelry, but I told him I wasn't interested.
You win some, you lose some. Summer rained out. Thanks for your time. Good night.
Who's that?
I told you, Mr. Mahoney.
I mean, do you know him?
No.
So he came up to you out of the blue to sell you jewelry.
He could see I was alone and
Perhaps he had something else on his mind. Next time, don't leave me alone so long.
Please, if we could have an earlier date for our wedding.
Let's see, September?
Well, how about next week?
Next week?
Is that possible?
All things are possible with God, but why are you in such a hurry?
Why?
Why?
Well, because we love each other.
Jeffrey, Holy Mother Church insists that an engaged couple spend an appropriate period of prayerful reflection and preparation before entering into the eternal state of matrimony.
Well, it seems to me like we've already spent the eternity reflecting and preparing, which has been very worthwhile.
What other reason prompts you to want to rush this?
It's hard to wait, Father.
Is that the only reason?
Well, isn't that enough?
I wouldn't call it a compelling reason in and of itself.
What do you consider compelling?
The possibility of imminent death, for one.
Well, you could get hit by a car just crossing the street.
Of course, we should always be prepared to meet our maker, but I was speaking more of such situations as a state of war.
So I guess a tough road schedule wouldn't count as compelling.
Is there something you'd like to tell me now, or in the privacy of the confessional?
No. No. No, Father.
Are you sure?
Not anything I can think of. Not anything in particular.
Let me speak frankly. Jeffrey, is your fiancée's physical condition normal and appropriate for a woman entering into marriage?
Do you mean, is Ginger having a baby?
Is she?
Well, hell no. I mean, no, Father. No.
I'm relieved to hear it.
You thought I wanted to hurry up the marriage because Ginger was having a baby?
The thought occurred to me.
No, not at all. Not even a little bit. That would be a reason to move up the date. No, I can see where you think that might be the case, but no, that's not the case, not in any way, shape, or form.
Then if that's not the case, I see no reason to change the date.
It was a pipe dream. We invested every penny we had, Abel, and we can't get it back. There's not much standing between us and the poorhouse.
If my mother hadn't gotten sick, we could have made it.
No.
We could. Good morning, Mother.
You were sleeping so late, you almost missed morning.
Those muffins smell good.
We cannot eat off that. That is that crinoline platter Ruth Sloan said I chipped.
It's chipped from the underside. It won't show for serving.
Did you buy that at the church?
No, I went through everything Mrs. Sloan donated to the rummage sale.
I thought we weren't going to do that.
You weren't going to do that.
Next thing I know, I'll be eating on Spanish moss.
I did not take the Spanish moss. I took the crinoline platter, the Nippon salt and pepper shaker, and a vase.
A gilded vase?
Mm-hmm.
With a man holding a basket?
Yes, but I didn't take the Spanish moss. What is the matter?
Come in.
Caroline's working late tonight. So you have yourself one free babysitter. Did you go to the movies? I'll watch Emma.
Or you, Emma, and I all can go for a walk.
No. You need to get out.
Okay, fine.
Something is wrong?
Yeah, I've been feeling screwy lately.
Screwy?
Loony. Certifiable.
That's so.
Right.
I think no.
Gina, I'm not perfect. I've told a lie or two in my day, but never when it was important. Caroline says that her mother sends her money. I can't complain. It's swell. I love the extra dough. But when I met her mom, she was as poor as a church mouse.
Now mother has money.
Caroline says she got a job, but there are times when I swear I got a fin in my wallet and it's gone. And I can't for the life of me remember spending it. Maybe it's me, maybe it's my lousy memory. But lately at night, strange ideas just come to me. That time she ran away, she said to the Y, maybe she was with another man. Why am I running at the mouth? It could be a full moon. Go to the movies, get out of here.
You no go?
No. Leave me and Emma alone. I want to babysit.
Hank, look what I found. Your fourth grade essay. My favorite family in the world. Did you know I kept it?
No.
I read it once in a while whenever I need cheering up. I took your dark suit to the cleaners, so I'll be ready Wednesday in case you're wondering what happened to it.
I'm not going to the wedding. I'm moving out.
Born to lose.
It's a great song.
What's the matter with this guy? I wish there was something else. Heaven brought me pain.
All my life, I've always been.
It surely is, friend, but there are a lot of other great songs in this jukebox.
You don't even know what you're playing.
I know what I'm not playing, and to the rest of my customers, that's what counts.
Oh, well, what are you not playing?
I'm not playing what you played 8 times in a row.
How I long to always have you near.
Oh, everybody's a damn wet blanket.
You've grown tired, and now you say we're through. Born to lose.
Let me have another beer.
Now I'm losing you.
You sure you can handle it?
No, I'm not. That's why I want one.
Thank you.
Homefront.
I met a fine woman, Mama. You'd like her.
Ask her over. Your mother can cook something special.
I have to get her to America first. She's French.
You mean white?
We had a spy and you found him out. Now, who's yours?
I haven't the foggiest notion. We all heard the same rumors.
About Linda?
No, I'm talking about your wife.
Anne, we were going to start 20 minutes ago.
I'm sorry, Father. We're just waiting for my eldest son.
I'm Ted Koppel. Later on Nightline, tennis great Arthur Ashe. Today he became the latest public figure to announce that he has AIDS. Tonight, a conversation with Arthur Ashe.